Meanwhile, charges set to be filed against Bureau of Corrections officials for participating in illegal activities at the state penitentiary. Recent inspections in jails netted thousands of illegal contraband, including beer and drugs. Several inmates have identified officials behind the entry of the unauthorized items. Bucor officer in charge Gregorio Catapang, who took over for suspended chief Gerald Bantag, reiterates he won't tolerate any illegal activities under his watch.
Hopefully, dito sa Bucor, hindi naman ganun katagal ang reforms na gagawin natin. Siguro, hopefully, in within the term of the president, may makikita kayo. Actually, baka one buwan may makikita kayong pagbabago. Right now nga, itong one month ko na pag-upo ko dito, may kakasuhan ako ng mga opisyal. Talagang sobra yung ginagawa nila. I'm not tolerating illegal activities inside the Bucor.
Meanwhile, investigators failed to reach a definitive conclusion on what killed the alleged middleman in the murder of broadcaster Percy Lapid. But inmates who admitted to taking part in the middleman's death provided new details on how they killed him. We need to warn our viewers the details of this exclusive report by Nico Bawa may be disturbing.
The NBI has finished the full autopsy report on the body of Jun Villamor, the inmate who died in his cell after he was identified as the middleman in the murder of broadcaster Percy Lapid. The report includes the results of the toxicology and histopathology tests. The cause of death is undetermined. No wounds and bruises were observed in the neck and head. No injuries were seen in the lungs either. The results of the NBI's autopsy isn't that different from the autopsy findings of forensic pathologist Dr. Raquel Fortun. She conducted a second autopsy requested by the Mabasa family.
I was prepared already to say it was a possible homicide, but I just did not know how it could have happened. And when Secretary Remulla informed me of information that they got that it was a plastic bag, I said, okay, that is consistent with the findings, actually.
According to forensic pathologist Dr. Cecilia Lim, wounds and bruises are normally seen in victims of suffocation, but it's possible that marks won't be seen in some cases where there is no struggle.
You will be struggling, yes, to prevent somebody from hurting you. They're trying to restrain you and all that. So you do expect to find injury. Why would an adult not be struggling if somebody's trying to hurt him? Was he drunk? Was he drugged?
In the sworn statement of one of the inmates who was ordered to kill Villamor, he says the order came from upstairs and referred to an office. Villamor was left alone when all inmates from the second floor dormitory where he was staying were asked to leave the area. On Friday afternoon, the NBI conducted a reenactment of how the four inmates killed Villamor. They narrated that Villamor initially pleaded for his life, but he did not resist even after a plastic bag was used to cover his head.
Nung sinukutan ninyo si Villamor, lumaban pa ba siya?
Hindi na po.
Anong ginawa niya?
Para pong tanggap niya na po sa sarili niya mamamatay na siya.
Hindi siya nanlaban?
Hindi po. Kahit mag-hysterical po, meron po siya pagkakataon na pwede po siya mag-hysterical, hindi niya po ginawa.
While he has no words for Villamor's family, he regrets his taking his life.
Ano naramdaman mo nung ganun na siya?
Ano po, una-una, sir, takot eh. Takot. Pangalawa, konsensya kasi kakosa namin siya.
Okay, may pagsisisi ka ba?
So far, the NBI has taken sworn statements from the three commanders who were instructed to hatch the plan to kill Lapid. The inmate from Palawan who coordinated with them, the inmate tapped by Villamor, and another one from a group of inmates involved in the killing of Villamor. The DOJ added that they value the cooperation of the inmates and understand their security concerns. They will be allowed to stay under the NBI's custody while the investigation is ongoing. Nico Bawa, ABS-CBN News.